Next example we take is for the question that we have to find irrational number between 1/7 and 2/7. If we find out the values of 1/7, we get 0.12857. These numbers are recurring. And the other way, if we find out the values of 2/7, 0.285714. We have to identify one irrational number. You must be remembering that irrational number means non-recurring and non-terminating decimal number is called as a irrational number. So from this one, we can make any number between these two numbers. Let us start making a number between these two numbers. Here there is 1, here there is 2. It should be greater than 1. So I don't make it greater, I keep it as 1. 4, so it should be greater than 4, I make it 5. Now whatever number I write will be greater than this number. Obviously the first number is 1 and here it is 2. So this number is going to be smaller than this number. Now I can add any digits, any number of digits which I want, and we can say that this is a required irrational number. Next we move on to exercise 1.3 and try to take some questions. So the question number 1 says, write following in decimal form and what kind of decimals they are. So let us say the second one I do, which is 1/11, what kind of a decimal is this I have to show. So let me solve this. Lines are 99, 1, 0 here, 0 here, lines are 99. So here if we see this number on division, we obtain is 0.090909. We see that 09 is continuously repeated. So decimal format of this number is 0.090909 repeating. Can be also written as 0.09, right? And it is non-terminating. It is not ending. Not ending means it will keep on moving and moving. So that is termination means end. So this will not end. So this is non-terminating and it is repeating or recurring. The same numbers are repeated again and again. So non-terminating recurring decimal is this number. Next question I take is the first one of the third number, 0.6 bar. We have to express this in P upon Q form. So let us say x is equal to 0.6666. It goes on moving. Since one number is repeated, I multiply with the 10. It becomes 6.666. That can be written as 6 plus 0.6666. This is nothing but our assumption x. So substituting this assumption here, 10x equal to 6 plus x, x is taken on the left hand side, x is equal to 6 by 9, 3 3 are 9, 2 3 are 6. So 2 by 3 is the P upon Q format for this number. There is one more question in the same exercise which asks whether this square root of 23 is rational or irrational. In order to identify whether it is rational or irrational, we have to find out the square root of 23. If we find out the square root of 23, we get as 4.795831523312. It is non-terminating and non-recurring also. No digits are repeating again and again, and also it is not ending. Hence these both conclusions leads us that the square root of 23 is irrational number.